This is FM Gold channel of All India Radio Delhi. Today is World Homeopathy Day. Those small sugar tablets that attract many among us, yet there are a lot many who don't subscribe to this type of disease management. But those who have got themselves treated by homeopathy do also swear that this is the best kind of treatment available. All these questions must automatically be springing up in your mind also when you might have come across the fact that today is World Homeopathy Day. So let us try to get answers of at least some of these questions. On the other side of this call, we are right now joined by Dr. Yogendra Jhala, a homeopathy practitioner from Jaipur. Dr. Jhala, our best wishes to you on this World Homeopathy Day. My first question is, what is the significance of this day?
The significance of this day is that the inventor of homeopathy, Samuel Christian Friedrich Hahnemann, started Hahnemann. It was his birthday. He was born in 1755 in Germany. So we celebrate his birthday as a centenary or Jayanti on this 10th April of every year.
Dr. Jhala, how is homeopathy different from other pathies?
Homeopathy is different from other pathy because we treat human beings from them, and all the scientific work or research is done on human beings so that the symptoms collected from the patient are different from, it will not be same with person to person. And we, all the symptoms are taken which has medicine similar symptoms. It is based on the similar symptoms which drug has and the patient has. We finalize which symptoms are equal, and we find what symptoms are in medicines and the patient is conveying us the symptoms. It is based on symptoms.
Okay, this is a treatment. It's based on symptoms. And you want to say that every person is different from the other person. His physiology is different. Treatment, homeopathy has got that much of flexibility where it can suit to various persons.
And no one person will be similar. Like if you have a common cold, the first person comes to you, he will be sneezing, his nose will be running. And second person comes to you, he feels cold and he is better in warm room. The other person comes, he's got hoarseness in voice, he's got headache. Third person comes, he's got burning in eyes. Other one comes out, body ache, headache, and throat is paining. And other one going, he's got burning eyes, face hot. And the one feels cold, one feels better in hot, other feels cold. So all these patients in homeopathy, it will not be the same. The different medicines for different persons, it will be different. Like first person which came with this, we will give aconite. To second person, we will give allium sepa. Third person, we will give arsenic because burning is there. Third person, watering of eyes is there. Similarly, another medicine will be given. So it is totally different from allopathy.
It is believed that patients feel that there is a lot of precautions that one has to take if he is taking treatment by homeopathy.
No,
what kind of precautions a patient has to take while undergoing treatment in homeopathy?
Yes, because certain things are there which antidotes the medicine. Like example, if you take the medicine and you drink coffee, then it will antidote the medicine which you have taken. And if you eat something, onions, garlic and all, the medicines in homeopathy which are produced from herbs, shrubs, trees, leaves, it will antidote the medicine.
So which means that whatever the practitioner is telling you, you have to be religiously following it.
You have to religiously follow. So before taking any medicines and after taking medicine, 10 minutes you have to keep the gap. After 10 minutes you can take anything, but this precaution is to be taken. And these medicines are in small quantity, not like allopathy. You have to take number of pills. We give a single dose in which the different pills may be different, 4 to 6 pills, 5 pills, or 10 drops or 20 drops, the medicine will be single medicine. We have no side effect.
Is it also true that you don't have to touch this medicine?
Yes. You don't have to touch the medicine because the medicine is already put. These all medicines are being made in alcohol. So if you touch or you keep open the medicines, it will evaporate. And by touching the medicines, you may, if your heart, hands are dirty or you touch something else, then they will be affected. The medicine's efficacy will go down. It will not work.
Dr. Sahib, is it also true that the treatment in homeopathy is very slow and lengthy?
No. Lengthy, it's not slow. If somebody comes to you, he's sneezing and watering nose, it will not take. It is acute disease. So immediately if you give medicine, within 5 to 7 minutes, the sneezing and the watering of the nose will come. Secondly, you say it takes long period because people come very late to the homeopath. After all, trying all the medicines, they come to homeopath, and when the disease becomes chronic, then it will take time. Like kidney stone is there, gout is there, asthma is there. They have tried all medicines. So immediately we give relief. Only thing is, in emergencies like accidents, head injury, if he's unconscious, or if he's got heart attack, then immediately you have to go to allopath. Okay. There are medicines, but it will take time. In emergencies and in heart attacks and all, you have to go to the allopath only.
You want to say that only chronic illness takes time to recover?
Take illness types. Actually, he will be benefited, but he will be completely cured after some time. It takes time. And secondly, the man comes with the vital force, our drugs act on vital force. That is the immunity of the human being. And immunity of the human being, we can increase slowly and make it permanently so that it is not deranged by small little things, whether cold and amelioration from cold or amelioration with hot, cold. So we have to see all the things, situations and climate also.
People also argue that this is a trial and error method. How true is this?
No, this is not true. If your selection of medicine is fine, if you select the symptoms of the drug and the patient's symptoms, definitely it will shoot. Immediately within 5 minutes, he will get relief. If some patient comes to you for a stomach ache, pain in the stomach, and he says, I got this pain from here to here, and I get relief from bending. And when I bend, it gives me relief. So we'll give colocynth. And this is the medicine. While bending, the pain comes in the stomach. It will definitely, within 5 minutes, the pain will go.
About training in homeopathy, do we have regular degrees now in India?
Yes, yes. There are degrees. Previously, it was BHMS, Bachelor of Medicine Surgery in homeopathy. And now, after some time, it got converted into Bachelor of Medicine and Coronary. Nowadays, it is MD also, Master of Medicine in homeopathy. Master of Medicine in homeopathy is done in Materia Medica, Pharmacy, Pharmacology. For this, you have to pass 12th class in science stream. Then you can join any of the colleges in the world. Abroad, you have to go and pass MBBS course, life in Germany and all. They will not allow you from here to, until unless you are MBBS or equivalent to MBBS in Germany, first they have to pass.
Which means in Germany, it is homeopathy is an extension of allopathy. First, you have to become an MBBS doctor.
Yes, yes.
What about India?
No, India is not necessary. Only homeopathy can do it. Some of the allopaths have converted into homeopath also. And this Hahnemannian, Christian Friedrich Hahnemann Samuel, he was an allopath. He came across so many complications due to drugs. So he got converted into a homeopath while he was reading books. He used to translate some books in different languages. So he came across a cinchona bark,
okay,
which was the medicine from bark of a tree, which was named cinchona, which produces malaria symptoms. So he took the bark, boiled it, and made a medicine. And he himself took the medicine, cinchona bark medicine, that is mother tincture, for 10 to 30 drops for a week. Then similarly, he got chill and rigor fever like malaria. So when he treated the patient of malaria with this bark of cinchona, he got success. And he invented homeopathy from this cinchona bark. Homeopathy was invented by him in 1755.
Dr. Saab, as a closing shot, one last question. Why would you suggest homeopathy?
Because it is safe, efficacy. Even in children, it is best. In old people and women, it is sweet pills which can be taken easily, and it and mother tinctures which can be taken in water, which are very efficient, and it is safe and faster. It gives relief faster.
Thank you, Dr. Jhala. I know some of the questions were a little annoying to a practitioner who has treated many patients with this study, but these are the day-to-day worries that come in mind of most of the patients. Once again, many congratulations to you on World Homeopathy Day. Thank you.
Thank you.
You just heard a conversation with Dr. Yogendra Jhala, who is a homeopathy practitioner. This broadcast came to you from the FM Gold channel of All India Radio Delhi. Please stand by for our next announcement.